Attention, what you're seeing right now is not in slow motion. I repeat, not slow motion. This is perhaps the most incredible moment since last month when China's Fujian aircraft carrier showcased footage of three different carrier-based aircraft being launched. For the first time, we're witnessing its electromagnetic catapult's launch hook accelerate and then suddenly stop mid-motion. No steam, no hydraulics, just pure digital control and magnetic force. It might look like a small detail, but from an engineering perspective, its significance is enormous. So why is this brief pause such a big deal? The Fujian, the Chinese PLA Navy's third aircraft carrier and the first equipped with an electromagnetic launch system, has just been officially commissioned. The real question now is, can it truly challenge the dominance of America's supercarriers? On November 7th, 2025, while Americans were going about their daily lives, the People's Liberation Army Navy of China was holding a grand ceremony on Hainan Island, a strategically vital location in the South China Sea. The guest of honor? The newest and most advanced aircraft carrier, Fujian. But this isn't just another ship joining an already expanding fleet. The Fujian represents a technological leap that puts China in a very exclusive club, a club that until now had only one member, the United States. For decades, the sight of steam-belching catapults launching aircraft from American carriers has been a symbol of U.S. naval supremacy. It's a complex and powerful technology that has given the U.S. the ability to project power across the globe. China's first two carriers, the Liaoning and the Shandong, relied on a less advanced ski jump ramp, limiting the weight and fuel capacity of the aircraft they could launch. But the Fujian is a different beast altogether. It has leapfrogged steam catapults and gone straight to an electromagnetic launch system, or EMALS. This is the same cutting-edge technology found on the U.S. Navy's newest Ford-class carriers. The commissioning of the Fujian with its electromagnetic catapults front and center isn't just a national triumph for China. It's a clear signal to the world, and particularly to the United States, that a new era of naval competition has arrived. So, what's the big deal about electromagnetic catapults? To understand the significance of the Fujian, we need to geek out a bit on the technology. A ski jump ramp, like on China's first two carriers, is essentially a ramp that helps aircraft take off with an upward trajectory. It's a simpler system, but it has major drawbacks. Aircraft launched this way can't carry their maximum payload of fuel and weapons. This severely limits their range and combat effectiveness, and crucially, prevents the launch of heavy support aircraft like airborne early warning planes. Steam catapults, the workhorse of the U.S. Navy for over 70 years on the Nimitz class, use high-pressure steam to propel a piston that launches the aircraft. It's a proven and powerful system, but it's also mechanically complex, maintenance-intensive, and puts a lot of stress on the aircraft. Electromagnetic catapults, on the other hand, are a revolutionary step forward. They use a powerful electromagnetic field to accelerate the aircraft down the track. This system provides a smoother, more controlled launch, which is less stressful on the airframe. More importantly, EMALS can be fine-tuned to launch a wider variety of aircraft, from lighter drones to heavier, fully loaded fighter jets and early warning aircraft. This is a crucial capability that the Fujian now possesses. So let's go back to the footage at the beginning. For the first time, the Fujian's electromagnetic catapult system has shown just how powerful it really is. The launch hook accelerates to hundreds of kilometers per hour, then instantly decelerates to zero, with no aircraft attached. That might not sound dramatic, but here's why it's a huge deal. Stopping a launch at full power, without damaging the system, requires insane precision. The control software has to manage massive bursts of electrical energy in milliseconds, perfectly balancing acceleration, braking, and power recovery. In other words, this moment shows that China's EM catapult isn't just powerful, it's smart. When the U.S. Navy first tested the Ford-class EMALS system, empty run tests often overshot. The shuttle went too far because controlling that magnetic force is brutally complex. Fujian's clean stop means its control algorithms and feedback sensors are extremely advanced, possibly rivaling or even surpassing early U.S. performance. And here's another big point. Steam catapults can't do this. Once you open the valve, all the steam pressure must release. There's no way to hit the brakes, but an electromagnetic catapult can stop anytime, safely, digitally, instantly. So yes, that single stop you just saw? It's not just engineering. It's a message. China's carrier technology has truly entered the smart age. With its three electromagnetic catapults, the Fujian can launch heavier and more capable aircraft, like the new J-35 stealth fighter and the KJ-600 airborne early warning and control aircraft, with a full fuel load and a complete weapons package. This dramatically expands the operational range and combat power of the carrier's air wing. Think of it this way. The Fujian's fighters will be able to fly farther, stay in the fight longer, and carry more firepower than their counterparts on China's older carriers. The commissioning of the Fujian is a sobering moment. It signifies that China is closing the technological gap faster than many anticipated. But to understand its true impact, we need to move beyond the headlines and conduct a clear-eyed, side-by-side comparison with the gold standard of naval power, the U.S. Navy's Nimitz and Ford-class supercarriers. Heart of the carrier, propulsion and endurance. First, let's talk about what makes these warships tick. The most fundamental difference lies deep in their hulls, the power source. Both the Nimitz and Ford classes are nuclear-powered. Their A-1B reactors on the Ford class, for example, can operate for 50 years without refueling. This gives them practically unlimited range and endurance. The only things that force a U.S. carrier to head for port are the need for food, munitions, and crew rest. This allows a U.S. carrier strike group to deploy globally, stay on station for extended periods, and sustain high-tempo operations without being tethered to a vulnerable chain of refueling tankers. The Fujian, in contrast, is conventionally powered. At roughly 85,000 tons, it's a massive vessel, but it relies on burning fuel oil, just like its predecessors. This creates a significant logistical anchor. It limits the carrier's range and requires it to be accompanied by replenishment ships, which themselves are prime targets in a conflict. This dependency also means less internal space is available for aviation fuel and ammunition, potentially impacting the intensity of air operations it can sustain. An aircraft carrier is ultimately just a floating airfield. Its real striking power comes from its air wing. Here the comparison gets more nuanced. The U.S. carriers are bigger, displacing around 100,000 tons, and are designed to carry a larger air wing of 75 to 90 aircraft. The Fujian, being smaller, is expected to carry a complement of around 50 to 60 aircraft. But numbers are only part of the story. The composition is critical. A typical U.S. carrier air wing is a symphony of advanced aviation. FA-18 Super Hornets, F-35C Lightning II, and the indispensable E-2D Advanced Hawkeye, which acts as the fleet's airborne eyes and ears. Perhaps most importantly, it includes the EA-18G Growler, the most advanced airborne electronic attack aircraft in the world, capable of jamming and destroying enemy radar and air defense systems. The Fujian's projected air wing is impressive and closes the gap significantly. It will feature the new J-35 stealth fighter, a direct competitor to the F-35C. It will also carry the KJ-600, a turboprop airborne early warning plane that looks remarkably similar to the E-2D Hawkeye. This aircraft alone is a massive leap, finally giving a Chinese carrier strike group the long-range eyes that its predecessors lacked. There is also evidence of a J-15D electronic attack variant intended to fill the role of the Growler. However, for U.S. Navy, a key advantage remains in the maturity and integration of its platforms. The F-35C isn't just a stealthy fighter. It's a flying sensor node that shares data seamlessly with ships and other aircraft, creating a comprehensive picture of the battle space. The U.S. has spent decades perfecting this system of systems approach. China is just beginning this journey and integrating these complex new aircraft into a cohesive and effective fighting force will be a massive undertaking. Sortie rate is a core metric of a carrier's effectiveness. I in a naval battle, the winner might be the one who can put the most aircraft in the air, armed and ready, the fastest. This is where the Ford class, with its four EMALS catapults and advanced weapons elevators, was designed to shine, boasting a projected 30% increase in sortie rate over the older Nimitz class. the Fujian has 3 EMALS catapults but only 2 aircraft elevators, compared to the 4 catapults and 3 elevators on most U.S. carriers. This design choice will almost certainly limit how quickly it can launch and recover aircraft, meaning it will be unable to match the sheer operational tempo of a U.S. supercarrier in a sustained high-intensity conflict. Even with these American advantages, the arrival of the Fujian has profound strategic implications. An aircraft carrier is more than just a warship. It's a mobile piece of sovereign territory, a powerful tool for power projection and diplomacy. This directly impacts the long-standing U.S. strategy in the Pacific, which for decades has been built around the concepts of the first and second island chains. The first island chain, a series of islands running from Japan down through the Philippines, has traditionally been seen by U.S. planners as a barrier to contain China's naval forces. The second island chain, further out and anchored by the crucial U.S. territory of Guam, represents a vital line of defense and a staging area for American power. With the Fujian, China now has a credible tool to project significant air power beyond the first island chain and operate in the open waters of the Philippine Sea. A Fujian-led carrier strike group could effectively outflank the chain, putting U.S. and allied forces in Japan, the Philippines, and elsewhere at risk from multiple directions. Furthermore, this pushes China's sphere of military influence much closer to the second island chain. The extended range of the Fujian's air wing means that critical U.S. military installations on Guam are now under a more direct and potent threat. This forces the Pentagon to reconsider its force posture and the defense of what was once considered a secure rear area bastion. Essentially, the Fujian helps transform vast areas of the Western Pacific from a U.S.-dominated space into a highly contested environment. Looking ahead, a new chapter in naval competition. The commissioning of the Fujian is a landmark event that underscores the shifting dynamics of global power. While it is not a direct peer to a nuclear-powered American supercarrier, it is a technologically advanced platform that dramatically narrows the capability gap. It's a clear and undeniable challenge to a domain where the U.S. has long been the undisputed leader. It's not a reason to panic, but it is a wake-up call. The era of uncontested American naval supremacy is likely over. The future of the world's oceans will be defined by a new era of competition, particularly between the United States and China. This competition will be driven by technology, strategy, and the will to project power and influence across the globe. The Fujian is a symbol of China's ambition and its growing technological prowess. How the United States and its allies respond to this new reality will shape the geopolitical landscape for decades to come. The commissioning of this single ship with its electromagnetic catapults front and center has opened a new chapter in the great power competition of the 21st century. And the world will be watching to see what happens next.